When we think about Subhash Chandra Bose, we remember some incredible journeys. Like, he famously escaped house arrest in Calcutta in disguise in a car and then traveled by the frontier mail all the way to Peshawar, then to Kabul, and reached Nazi Germany at the height of the Second World War. And when he died, it was in a plane crash, and he was with his assistant, Habibur Rahman, getting ready to take off from Formosa, which is now Taiwan. But maybe the most intrepid and daring journey that Subhash Chandra Bose ever made is one that very few people know about, and even his biography is never recorded in detail until a couple of years ago. That's the journey he made from the northern tip of Germany in the year 1943 all the way to Asia in a submarine. The journey that would allow Bose to move his efforts to raise an Indian National Army out of Europe to Asia, from where he dreamt of marching into India and one day liberating Delhi. So, at the start of 1943, Bose was in Germany and he'd spent 2 years there trying to convince the Nazi leadership to recognize a free India and its government in exile. He'd had many meetings with von Ribbentrop, the foreign minister, and he'd even met Hitler. While he was in Germany, Bose started a family and he'd raised a small battalion from Indian prisoners of war who would eventually fight alongside the German army on the principle of opposing the British Empire. But essentially, Bose thought he was wasting his time. The Nazi racial ideology didn't allow them to believe in a free India, and Bose didn't believe in their war with the Soviet Union. What he wanted to do was to start afresh with the support of a new Axis power, which was still on the rise and which had actually conquered territory all the way up to India's eastern border, and which held tens of thousands of Indian jawans as prisoners of war, captured in places like Malaya and Singapore. And that was Imperial Japan. That was the army he believed he needed, and he was the leader he believed they were waiting for.
And the only way to get out of Germany now, to get to East Asia, was underwater in a submarine. This particular submarine was called the U-180, and it was a uniquely modified vessel. They had taken out the torpedo tubes to create extra hold space for cargo, which needed to be transferred to Germany's ally, Japan. So that cargo included technical papers, other information for the Japanese military, and special diplomatic correspondence. And finally, on February 9th of 1943, two civilian passengers arrived, Subhash Chandra Bose and Abid Hasan.
Bose and Hasan would spend 2 months aboard the U-boat, which is an intensely difficult place to live. It was confined and claustrophobic. It was dark, and Hasan wrote in his diary, "The fumes permeated everything. The bread we ate looked as if it was soaked in diesel oil, and the blankets seemed drenched with it." By mid-April, they had rounded the Cape of Good Hope and entered the Indian Ocean, and they were approaching the rendezvous point near Madagascar, where Bose and Hasan would part from the German U-boat and in the middle of the Indian Ocean make the crossing to a Japanese submarine. But this is where the story almost ended, and Bose's life with it. The submarine crew detected a British merchantman, but at the last minute they had engine trouble and had to surface within sight of the British ship, which, desperate to protect itself, tried to ram the submarine. In his book, Abid Hasan describes sitting with Bose and working, even at this moment, hearing the captain's voice over the submarine's communication system shouting, "Dive, dive, dive." Hasan says he saw death reflected in some of the faces around him. But he looked at Bose, who only said to him, "Hasan, I have repeated a point twice, and you are not noting it down." So Hasan, with violently beating heart and shaking fingers, went back to his dictation. The U-boat very narrowly escaped the situation. The U-boat managed to dive with minutes to spare, and the merchantman seemingly clipped its hull, but didn't cause any deadly damage. The submarine keeled to one side and dropped into the water and back to safety. On April 20th at the rendezvous point, they finally detected the Japanese submarine. And on those rough seas, Bose and Hasan did what no one had yet done during the Second World War. They became the first civilians to be transferred from submarine to submarine in open water. The German crew said goodbye, and Bose and Hasan climbed into a rubber dinghy, crossed the pitching waves to board the Japanese submarine, which carried them over further weeks to Sabang in Indonesia, from where Bose traveled on to Singapore and to Tokyo, into the command of the Indian National Army, and the final and most epic portion of his life.